PrinceOfTheWild.com. I have finally got a YouTube channel up and going, and I am finally doing this trailer walk around. It has been far too long, and I've had plenty of people ask me about it. So, without further ado, here we go. Now, when it comes to off-road trailers, in my personal opinion, there are three components that are critical. One is this off-road hitch right here. You want something that will articulate so your trailer stays level when your vehicle is not. Two, you want a spine that goes from the front of the trailer all the way through the bottom and the back of the trailer. And what that does is that stabilizes and strengthens up the frame so you don't get too much tweaking and twisting on the actual shell while you're off-road. The last thing, very important. Now, I'm not saying that a straight axle isn't good, but what I'm saying is, for my own preference, I prefer the Timbrin independent suspension system that comes with this trailer. Now, what the independent suspension does, it allows you to get that articulation very similar to what you would get on your Jeep or your vehicle when you're unhooked with the sway bars. That's why I like it. It keeps everything kind of level while the wheels move up and down. Okay, so getting back to the trailer. There are three types of trailers. Category one was the small trailer that you pull that has a rooftop tent on it. I already had a rooftop tent. I had a great setup on my Jeep, so I didn't want that. I didn't think the experience was gonna be different enough. Category three is that really nice, high-end luxury trailer that can run into the tens of thousands of dollars. For me personally, not exactly in the budget, and I know that for most people, that's probably not a price point that they can jump into. So then that leads us to category two, the sweet spot, right in the middle. And I found a camper company out of Florida called Runaway Campers. What they have is they have this off-road trailer that's called the Venturist. And the Venturist model is what we see here right behind me. And what that is that's their off-road version of a camper, right? They do mini campers. They have a lot of road trip campers. They have small campers that you can pull behind your motorcycle. They do all kinds of stuff. But what we're looking for in kind of that overland off-road experience is we want that off-road camper. And what makes that different from the other road trip campers are those three components that I was talking about. So right from the get-go, Runaway Campers Venturist gives you the articulating hitch, gives you the spine through the frame, gives you the independent suspension. And it can come on either, I believe it's 33 inch or 35 inch tires with bead locks, straight from Method, right from the factory. So once you get it, you are set up, you can jump in that thing and you can go for the weekend. But here's what's great about it. The price point is about $8,000. That's very different than most trailer companies out there. So it almost allows just about anybody to get into that, right? So I met the family. I really like the family. You know, I say this all the time. I'm a people person, not a product person. So the people come before the product for me. And what that does is that assures me that I get great customer service. It assures me that I get a high quality of a product. You know, when they put character into their products, that comes from the type of people they are. So, Runaway Campers, based out of Florida, check them out at runawaycampers.com if you want to check what they have to offer. But they're Venturist. Let's take a look at it. Okay, we talked about the company, we talked about the quality. Now let's get into the camper itself. This thing comes pretty packed with specs that you don't have to pay premium for, which is kind of nice when it gets to the price point that you're getting into this camper for. One is an air conditioning unit, runs off a generator. I actually removed mine, but it's a great feature for most people. Two, it comes with this cargo basket at the front of the camper, which will allow you to load it up with boxes, wood, that kind of thing. I actually love these little roam boxes. So I mounted mine and it's secured down there. I just put locks on the hinges so people can't walk in there and take the stuff out. I keep more like tools and gear, stuff like that. It's a great place to keep firewood, stuff like that. Moving down the line, we'll get to the doors. They are aluminum frames, lightweight composite material on the door, keeps it light. and they all have locking latches, handles, and on the inside, there's a nice deadbolt feature, just kind of, as you go to sleep, it gives you a little more peace of mind, a little more security or safety. From there, they come with these big off-road fenders that are very flat. I actually use these things as storage, as tabletops, as all kinds of stuff. But it's really nice because they do go past the tire. So it keeps rocks, mud, all that kind of junk from kicking up and blasting the people behind you. Each side has its own opening window, which also locks, and tinted glass. They do come with this cool screen that you can open and shut, which is also a cool feature. Tons of bugs out here on the West Coast with the mountains and stuff like that, so it's nice to keep these screened up. Going up to the top, you have a rack system that you can run a rooftop tent on if you would like. If not, you can have cargo baskets. I actually leave mine blank because I'll just throw up there any kind of extra stuff that I may want to. Again, with the Roam boxes, I have this really long box that fits perfectly on this rack. They come with an awning. The awning that is on the trailer from the factory, I actually removed and I replaced with this, again, another Roam Adventure Company awning. I really dig the brand, I really dig the product, so this is a very cool feature that I just wanted to replace the original one with. Going on to the back of the camper now, right here, we would have stabilization jacks. Okay, I removed mine. Not necessarily the smartest thing to do, but I am replacing it with a modified thing that I'm taking the same concept, and I did a hitch mount stabilization jack that I can remove, right? These things bang around a lot. Honestly, they just bugged me, so I took them off. So I actually had a friend of mine build me a shelving system for this camper. This comes without it, which is kind of nice because it gives a big entrance to get in and out of, and it also, there's plenty of airflow with both of these doors open. But I needed storage. What I found is that my stuff would just pile up inside. So instead of having that happen, I decided to come up with a system that a friend of mine built to organize my stuff. And what I can actually do is I can put about a week's worth of stuff just in this little area that allows me to be out off the grid kind of thing for an entire week. Inside the sleeping quarters, there is plenty of room. I built the shelving to give me 16 inches, maybe 15 inches of space from front to back for the shelves, which left me actually 6'6" of sleeping area. I'm 6'3", that gives me 3 extra inches, perfect for me. In the front of the sleeping area are 2 shelves. One comes from the factory, the other I added because I wanted the extra space. I like to hang my 6'7" design mounts from that second shelf, and what it does, it allows me to keep my phone hanging by the charging system, so it's just out of the way and over there. The other is so I can mag mount my iPad to it and watch movies. It's kind of cool sometimes if it's really cold out or rainy or snowy, just kind of kick back inside here. It's nice and comfortable. Watch a movie before you go to bed. The same friend that made my shelves, that put in my lighting, also installed a very cool battery system that he came up with, and it's a box with some switches, some USB ports, a battery meter, and a cigarette lighter. For this type of simplicity, you really don't need anything more than that. That's it, guys. This is the Venturist from Runaway Campers. Now, before we wrap this up, I do think it's important just to mention a couple cool things that I did extra to the camper. Number one was I went down to Linex HB and I Linexed this thing from top to bottom. We sealed it up, even the undercarriage is Linexed. I think it makes a very durable product that keeps the elements out, right? Especially water. I think that was important. The other thing I did is I swapped out the tires for Yokohama Geolanders. It does come with a nice tire on it from the factory, but I am a Yokohama guy. I swapped out the tires to my guys at Yoko. I really like them. The third thing I did was I changed out the awning that came from the factory for the Roam Adventure Company awning. Added a couple Roam boxes as well. From there, remember, I put in the shelving, I put in the lighting. Other than that, this thing is ready to hook up to your vehicle and take off-road on any adventure straight from the factory floor. That's it, guys. Thank you for hanging in there with us. This, I promise you, will get better. It's our first video, but you hung tough and I do appreciate it. Please, like this video, share it with your friends, and subscribe to our channel.